Hi there, welcome back. Dan again from CleanGuru. So one of the most common questions we hear is, you know, why didn't I land that job? Why didn't they pick my bid? They went with another cleaning company. Well, there can be a lot of reasons. Let's start looking at some of the really big ones now. So these are like janitorial bidding mistakes. So the first janitorial bidding mistake we want to look at is not really knowing what you're bidding on. Well, how can that be? Well, it can be very easy to happen. Let's say you go in and you think you have some rough information about the bid. You think you know the frequency, you think you know the kind of floor surfaces, and you think you know the size of the area to be cleaned. But all of those questions are critically important. So for example, if you think the frequency is 3 days a week, but it turns out there are several locations that only once a week need to be taken care of, man, that's a big difference when it comes to bidding. What can even be a bigger difference is sometimes a building owner or a property manager may not remember to, may have made a mistake or simply forgotten to tell you, or you may not have asked them, what exactly, what areas have to be cleaned in a building and what don't. I mean, that may sound crazy. In fact, someone may say, listen, they told me the building is 62,000 square feet, that's what has to be cleaned. Well, if I said to you, well, did you really go through and ask them, are there any areas in the building that don't need to be cleaned as often or not at all? It is shocking, or at least surprising, how often that that's the case. You may go through and find out when they really take out all that area, that's a huge area we never use. It may not be 61,000, it could be 49,870. Well, that big difference in square footage is a huge difference when it comes to bidding. Later on, if you never knew the real actual cleanable square footage that you needed to take care of, you may have very understandably bid way too high. You may actually be upset thinking to yourself, why did that other cleaning company get that job? They must have underbid it. Look at that low price I think that I heard they charged for that. Well, it may not have been a low ball bid. It may have been a competitive bid based on what they found out was the real dimensions or the real size of the cleanable area to be taken care of. So this is the first big janitorial bidding mistake we wanted to look at, and that's not really knowing what you're cleaning, what the bid is for. Now you might think to yourself, well, the manager should have told me that. Well, I think it's best to say very often it can happen that they don't, and we should take the responsibility to at least say, listen, is there anything I need to see in the building that may not need to be taken care of or that's set aside? Boy, can that getting the square footage right make a huge difference. Till next time, remember, you can do this. You really can.